I want to thank you all for coming and for sharing in this special day. My special thanks to all the speakers and panel members. This event actually brings together students, staff and faculty, past and present. And I looked it up, and in the history of the department, there have been 15 department chairs. And I'm very pleased that actually four of my predecessors are here today. And if you wouldn't mind, I'm going to say your names, and you can sort of stand up so the students can recognize you. Al Pence. Is Al here? David Thomas. Dick Hertzberg, who I know is receiving the award. And Slade Cargill. Now, of course, one of the sort of important things we're going to do today is recognize a new set of distinguished alums, and you'll be meeting them all later. But I'd like to recognize our distinguished alums who are actually here today as well. And there are a few of them. So Al, we have you again, but you don't have to stand up if you don't want to. Claire Rimnack. George Krauss. Al Romig. Okay, Don Richard actually was going to come. He unexpectedly had to go to Afghanistan, but he did send a really nice letter where he paid tribute to his professors, and he said what a wonderful experience he had in the department. The materials program here now stretches back over a century, and we really have a rich history. You're going to be hearing about that a little bit from me, but from Mike. But at this moment, I would like to take a few moments just to remember a couple of our faculty who passed away this year. So, Joe Goldstein, his list of accomplishments are very many, and I'm not going to go through them all, except I will say I think he would be regarded as the father of electron microscopy here at Lehigh, and he and Dave Williams started a tradition which really continues to flourish. And we have our internationally recognized microscopy school, our nanocharacterization lab, and of course the emphasis we have on characterization in our research and undergraduate programs. The other person I'd like to say a few words about is Don Smith. Don was a dear friend, and like Joe, he was a distinguished scholar. He was a world's authority on defect chemistry and perovskite-related materials, and was elected to the National Academy of Engineering. He joined Lehigh as director of the Materials Research Center in 1971, and although he officially retired in 1995, he actually continued to be active, coming in regularly and participating in our events. They were both outstanding educators, researchers and mentors, and we'll miss them both. Okay, so the theme of my opening remarks, which are very brief, is actually encapsulated by this quote from the French writer Jean-Baptiste Alphonse Karr. He wrote, "Plus ça change, plus c'est la même chose," which actually translated means the more things change, the more they stay the same. So when I started looking at our material, our department's history, I was struck not only by the changes, and of course there have been a lot, but also by how many of our traditions have endured. But I wanted to look first at the south side, and that of course has changed a lot. I found some old photos. Now can anyone tell me where this is? 5 points, very good, yes. How about here? Well, the train station, but I think this church here sort of gives it away a little bit. If you look at that church there. So this is 4th and New. This is the junction of 4th and New Street. So as Alfred Mutz, who was the chairperson from 1952 to 56, he wrote a book, 97 Years of Metallurgy at Lehigh, and he describes the Student Metallurgical Society, and this is in 1917, and what they did as a society, and I want you to have a look at this. They had a Christmas banquet and a picnic in May featured by a softball game. And it turns out the RMSE team, our softball team, are still very successful. They were league champions in 2013 and 2014, beating our old enemies, the Chemies. And runners up in 2011 and 2015. Now what about if we look at the curriculum? So this is the curriculum from 1873. This is the freshman and sophomore year, and there are a couple of courses which would be strange to us. Things like farm surveying, rhetoric and logic. But when we go to the sort of junior and senior years, there's a few things that look, sort of look familiar. Calc, crystallography, metallurgy, things like that. So maybe there are some things that haven't changed that much. But one thing that, again, was very striking to me was that back then, there was 20 credit hours of a foreign language. And you know, especially since today, we have so much emphasis on globalization and foreign travel. I think Lehigh was ahead of its time there. Now, I mentioned that microscopy is sort of a recurring theme in the department. And this is the sort of microscope that people would have been using, you know, in the early days. Arlen has one not that different, actually, in his office. It's actually a museum piece. It's very nice. And Mike helped me find this, which is the first micrograph, published micrograph from someone at Lehigh. And this is from an undergraduate thesis in 1906. And I think most of you would be able to tell me what that microstructure is. Very good. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, you get an A, Dick. Right. Of course, nowadays we still do microscopy, but we do it differently. We now have our atomic resolution microscope when we look at atoms. So our techniques become more advanced, but what we do sort of stays the same. So in closing, I would like to just draw your attention to, these are the words of Charles Richards, who was the Lehigh president, 1922 to 1935. And he insisted that good teaching and research go hand in hand. This has always been and always will be a core principle of our department. So I guess it's true, the more things change, the more they stay the same. Thank you.